We are grateful today for rain, for a little bit of cooling, at least temporary though it may be. We ask, Father, that you be among us, lead us, open our ears, open our mouths, help us to gain from what you're offering to us. In your name, amen. Today's video is on the leadership of the church over the years, and fascinating video. Saw a lot of pictures of people that I'd either almost forgotten or haven't seen in years. So without further ado.
Anabaptist leader Menno Simons wrote, quote, "Fellow laborers with me in the ministry, guardians and trumpeters are they, spiritual pillars are they, messengers of peace are they, bishops and overseers are they, shepherds are they, teachers are they, the light of the world are they called, the salt of the earth are they called, ministers are they called, representing Christ. As leaders of the church, brothers and sisters, serve, but do not lord it." End of quote. In its 100 years of ministry, Buhler Mennonite Church has been blessed with a variety of faithful ministers. But what do we mean by ministers? On the top of each worship bulletin handed out on a Sunday morning, you will find the following listing of ministers. Lead pastor, Wilmer T. Harder. Youth leader, Sonia Good. Ministers, all of us. All members of our fellowship are ministers in some fashion. That follows the Mennonite understanding of the priesthood of all believers. Buhler Mennonite Church, however, has a strong tradition of calling at first bivocational and then full-time lead pastors whose job is to preach, teach, counsel, visit, and lead based on the gospel of Jesus Christ. Because at its founding, Buhler Mennonite Church was part of the multi-site Hoffnungsau Mennonite Church, its pastors would have rotated their service with Buhler Mennonite Church and Inman Mennonite Church. At first, Hoffnungsau Mennonite, and thereby Buhler Mennonite Church, followed the traditional Low German Mennonite Church polity. In this polity, one person was elected as Ältester, which in German literally means, quote, "the oldest," and more to the point, elder. It does not, however, correspond with most North American Mennonites' understanding of the term elder. It is closer to the term bishop or overseer. The Ältester was the only one who could ordain, baptize, or serve communion. The Ältester was often the last word on matters of faith and church. In addition to the Ältester, several, quote, "teachers of the word," end of quote, or preachers, were elected from within the congregation. They would help preach on Sundays, especially as they rotated through the Inman and Buhler church sites. They would aid the Ältester in many different ways in dealing with the spiritual well-being of the church. This group was rounded out by the election of one deacon. All of these positions were lifetime callings. This group was commonly referred to in Low German as the Lehrdienst, or the teaching service, or the teaching servants. This church polity is still practiced within most of the more traditional Low German Mennonite churches found in Canada, Mexico, Bolivia, and Paraguay. Dietrich Gedert was the first Ältester of Hoffnungsau Mennonite Church, serving from 1874 until 1900. In 1902, 18 months after the death of Elder Dietrich Gedert, the church elected Abraham Ratzlaff, and he served as elder until 1925. A.J. Dick succeeded Ratzlaff as elder of Hoffnungsau Mennonite Church, serving from 1925 to 1946. Before A.J. Dick was elected as elder, he often preached at Buhler Mennonite Church, even before its independence. At a March 20, 1923 evening congregational meeting called due to the attempted resignation of Buhler Mennonite Church's pastor P.R. Voth, the Buhler congregation resolved, quote, to extend a call to Brother A.J. Dick to become the minister of our church, end of quote. Following the meeting, Buhler Church records include a typewritten paragraph in German from Hoffmannsthal Mennonite Church that says, quote, it is resolved that the request of the Buhler Mennonite Church to our dear minister brother, A.J. Dick, that he serve as their minister be rejected. That would mean he would leave our church, and we, the Hoffmannsthal congregation, would be suffering a deep loss that we do not want to go through, end of quote. Dick was not called by the Buhler Mennonite Church, but became the next Hoffmannsthal Mennonite Church elder. Hoffmannsthal discontinued the Älteste or elder polity after Elder Albert Gettert served in that capacity from 1946 to 1959. Abraham Ratzlaff was elder during the time that Buhler Hoffmannsthal Mennonite Church was established, and also when Buhler Mennonite Church became an independent church in 1920. Therefore, it can be said that Dietrich Gettert and Abraham Ratzlaff were essentially the first two pastors of the Buhler Mennonite Church American experience. Although the young Buhler Mennonite Church used the language of Älteste slash elder at the beginning of their ministry, this traditional polity model was not used at Buhler Mennonite. All the functions of the elder and the preacher or the teacher of the word were vested into a single pastor model with the help of several deacons, or at that time called the guardians of the poor and needy. From the beginning, Buhler Mennonite Church pastors received a salary to support their ministry. In 1920, Peter R. Voth was elected from within the congregation as the first pastor of Buhler Mennonite Church. He was born in Gnadenthal, South Russia, and was 4 years old when his family moved from Russia to Goslar, Kansas. In 1898, upon having graduated from Bethel College, he was ordained as a preacher into the Alexanderville Mennonite Church in Goslar, Kansas. He and his family moved to Gatibo, Oklahoma, where he was elected and ordained the Älteste or the elder of the Friedenthal Mennonite Church in 1917. Almost immediately during his tenure at Buhler Mennonite Church, it was decided to give, quote, the sisters, end of quote, the right to vote and take part in discussions and hold office as permitted. Transition from the German language to the English language in Sunday school and worship services began. In 1922, it was decided that since a number of the teachers in the Buhler School District attended Buhler Mennonite Church, that an English-speaking Sunday school class be organized. Under Pastor Voth, the language transition came slowly, and he called for the practice of tolerance and understanding and patience. At the beginning of his term, all sermons were preached in German, then three in German and one in English, then two in German and two in English. Eventually, after Pastor Voth's time, services transitioned entirely to English. In 1924, Reverend Voth resigned, but after a year of leave, during which Reverend A.J. Dick served as pastor, Reverend Voth accepted the call to again serve as pastor of Buhler Mennonite Church. He supplemented his income by doing jewelry and watch repair, a work that he enjoyed well into his 90s. Reverend Voth built the frame house, which was later the first sunshine home. The church grew in membership and in attendance, and in 1927 a new church building was constructed. In 1932, Reverend Voth cited health conditions as his reason to finally resign. The church accepted his resignation on the condition that he remain in his position until a new pastor had been hired. Reverend Voth baptized 140 people into the faith at Buhler Mennonite Church. Reverend Voth passed away in 1962. In 1933, Reverend John M. Suderman was called as the next pastor of Buhler Mennonite Church. A native of Poshwa, South Russia, Suderman came to the United States in 1878. Suderman was working as a bookkeeper in a lumberyard business in Reedley, California, when he became convinced that the Lord wanted him to take up full-time Christian ministry. In 1914, this conviction resulted in a call to serve as pastor of West Zion Mennonite Church in Mound Ridge, Kansas. He served in that role until 1921, when he joined the Bible department at Bethel College in North Newton, Kansas. In 1929, he became the superintendent of the Bethel Deaconess Home and Hospital in Newton, Kansas, for 3 years. Then in the spring of 1933, he became pastor of the Buhler Mennonite Church until the fall of 1938, when he suffered a moderately heavy heart attack. He passed away in 1964 after 40 years of full-time Christian service. In the 5 years that Reverend Suderman served at Buhler Mennonite Church, English ultimately replaced German as the language of worship, teaching, preaching, and business. He is remembered for his thoroughly worked out sermons and how he and his wife Clara made it their special ministry to visit the sick. Clara, with her many years of experience, was a great assistance to the Buhler Mennonite Church sewing societies. Missionary August Ewert, a missionary to China attending Bethel College, was asked to serve the Buhler Mennonite Church as a guest minister. His ministry was from October 1938 to June 1939. In the meantime, the ministerial committee had contacted and engaged Reverend J.F. Schmidt, a young minister who held a pastorate in Council Grove, Kansas. Schmidt began as pastor in June 1939 and served until October 1941. He preached his last sermon on November 16, 1941, with the text being 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 12. He is remembered as an excellent instructor of the youth in the principles of peace and nonviolence. After his service at Buhler Mennonite Church, he directed civilian public service camps in Marietta, Ohio, and Fort Collins, Colorado, until 1943. He joined the Bethel College speech and journalism staff in 1947 and served at Bethel College until he retired in 1981. He also served as Kauffman Museum curator and mayor of North Newton. The Buhler Mennonite Church Ministerial Committee, with humble hearts, several prayer meetings, and the blessings of the church, once more turned their faces towards Bethel College in North Newton, Kansas. The short history of Buhler Mennonite Church, written in 1988, says, quote, "The Holy Spirit most definitely led us to the home of Reverend A.E. Kreider. As the committee of five stopped in front of Reverend Kreider's home, the suggestion was made that only two should go into the house and inform him of our mission. Reverend Kreider was willing to serve our church as a guest minister." End of quote. Amos E. Kreider was a Bible professor at Bethel College and had pastored churches in Indiana and Illinois. In 1942, Bethel College made the arrangement that Reverend Kreider must take along a ministerial student every other Sunday. His first student, a young man from Vineland, Ontario, Canada, by the name of Henry Franzen, became a regular participant. After prayerful consideration, the church gave a formal call to Franzen to become its regular pastor. Reverend Franzen served Buhler Mennonite Church for 11 years until 1953. During this time, Buhler Mennonite Church celebrated its 25th anniversary and reached 350 members for the first time. One Buhler Mennonite Church document says, quote, "We can assured say that the Holy Spirit was favoring our church while Reverend and Mrs. Franzen were at its ministry," end of quote. During this time, in 1947, the church trustees were instructed to study the possibilities of building a Christian education wing. But Franzen would not stay to occupy the new pastor's study in the completed education wing. The wing was dedicated in 1954, and Reverend Franzen left in 1953 and became the founding pastor of Grace Mennonite Church in St. Catharines, Ontario. He died in Canada in 2001. He was the last Buhler Mennonite Church pastor to be born in Russia. Reverend P.K. Regier, a Bethel College graduate, served as part-time interim pastor until 1954. During this time, from 1950 to 1960, he also served as the executive secretary of the central offices of the General Conference Mennonite Church. He also served as interim pastor at Hoffnungsau Mennonite Church, Inman Mennonite Church, and First Mennonite Church of Mountain Lake, Minnesota, the home church of present-day Buhler Mennonite Church's pastor, Wilmer Harder. In 1954, Reverend Irvin E. Rickert, also a Bethel College graduate, was called to serve the Buhler congregation. Before coming to Buhler and during World War II, he served in civilian public service in forestry and conservation work in Colorado Springs, Colorado, and Claremont, California. After World War II, he was in charge of a crew of the so-called seagoing cowboys that cared for 750 horses that the United Nations Relief and Rehabilitation Service sent to Poland by ship. During his tenure at Buhler Mennonite Church, the education wing was dedicated, and in 1957, its mortgage paid off. In 1956, a committee was formed to organize visitations and singing in local hospitals, nursing homes, county homes, and other facilities. Representatives from the Deacon Board, Men's Fellowship, Young People's Union, Christian Endeavor, Women's Missionary Association, and the Sunday School Superintendent served on this committee, which existed until 1958. Reverend Rickert served midway into 1961 when he went on to other ministries like English editor for the Good News Bible of the American Bible Society. He held other conference-level leadership positions until his passing in 2008 in Souderton, Pennsylvania. Reverend P.K. Regier was again invited to serve as interim pastor, and he served until 1962. During his second tenure, a new modern design parsonage was built. Reverend Regier passed away in 1973 in Newton, Kansas. He was the last Buhler Mennonite Church pastor to be born in the 19th century. With a new parsonage, a new pastor, Harold Thiessen, was called by Buhler Mennonite Church. The parsonage was dedicated on May 27, 1962, and the Thiessen family moved right in. Reverend Thiessen, having grown up in Henderson, Nebraska, and also a graduate from Bethel College, came to Buhler from serving as pastor of the Sugar Creek Mennonite Church in Sugar Creek, Ohio. Reverend Thiessen was known for his relational approach and sense of humor, often connecting to the people by speaking Plautdeutsch. He connected well with the youth. During his tenure, the annual MCC relief sale was started, and like many other churches in Kansas, many of the people in the Buhler congregation put their time, energies, and monies into this growing ministry. Partly through these joint ministries and making connections with local pastors, there sprouted a growing appreciation and acceptance of other congregations, denominations, and people in the community, a beautiful growth that people continue to notice and appreciate. The congregation appreciated his ministry, and Reverend Thiessen recalls that, quote, "The executive committee decided to celebrate my ministry at 6 years. It was to be a surprise celebration. However, from time to time, I would take walks through the education wing to get a feel of what was happening in the classrooms. I noticed a piece of paper on the lectern in one of the classrooms. I looked at it and read it. It was the announcement of a surprise celebration of 6 years of ministry. And now, you all know it was a surprise when I read it, and even more surprising was the event." End of quote. In 1970, Reverend Thiessen resigned to accept the pastorate of First Mennonite Church in Mountain Lake, Minnesota, where consequently he became the first non-family visitor of present-day Buhler Mennonite Church pastor Wilmer Harder the day after he was born. Reverend Thiessen and Esther are retired and reside in North Newton. He still today is asked to fill the pulpit at Buhler Mennonite Church in the absence of the pastor. Dr. David C. Wadle was asked to serve as interim pastor from 1970 to 1972. He came to Buhler Mennonite Church having grown up in the Alexanderwald Mennonite Church in Goshall, Kansas, and had served as a pastor, civilian public service camp director, professor of Bible, academic dean, and president of Bethel College. The church council minutes state that during Dr. Wadle's service, the congregation addressed the issues of celebrating their 50th anniversary, of changing hymnals, the impact of the Vietnam War and its effect on young people, and assisting with the beginning of a campus ministry at Hutchinson Community College. Dr. Wadle was known as a man of rectitude, honor, and faith. He lived to the age of 102 and passed away in Goshall, Kansas in 2010. In 1972, the church called Reverend John Brown to serve as pastor. Seeing a need to bring together the young people living in the Buhler area, the Buhler Young People's Union, which included youth from Buhler Mennonite Church and Hebron Mennonite Church, was organized in 1974. A basketball team was formed and they played in the Youth Fellowship Basketball League. They met the second and fourth week of each month, and only once a month during the summers. On July 21, 1974, the first Sunday school picnic was held at Camp Menaska near Murdoch, Kansas. Starting in 1976, the church decided to reserve the last Sunday in June for worship services at Camp Menaska. Some members attended only the Sunday morning worship while others camped overnight. And those who camped overnight started the tradition of making pie iron or campfire pies. This tradition continues to the present day. In 1976, Reverend Brown and the Board of Deacons agreed that, quote, candidates for baptism should have the choice of baptism by sprinkling or by immersion, end of quote. And for the first time at Camp Menaska, Buhler Mennonite Church's new members were baptized by immersion. In July of 1976, Reverend Brown ended his ministry at Buhler Mennonite Church and moved to Washington State, where he presently resides. In August of 1976, Mountain Lake, Minnesota native and Bethel College graduate Reverend Abe Kraus was installed as the new pastor. During his years of service, several important changes took place. In May of 1977, the congregation voted on and approved an amendment to the Constitution which allowed women as well as men to serve as deacons. And in 1978, Leona Wall was nominated, elected, and ordained as the first woman deacon in Buhler Mennonite Church history. During the summer of 1977, Henry Brown, a second-year seminary student at Mennonite Biblical Seminary, served as a summer assistant pastor. Brown and his family also spent part of the summer serving the Inman Mennonite Church. During the summer of 1980, Janine Ewert, a sophomore at Bethel College, served as the summer assistant pastor. During the tenure of Reverend Abe Kraus, the congregation also pondered the idea of hosting a Vietnamese war refugee family. In 1978, Mennonite World Conference was held in Wichita. This occasion provided a great opportunity for area churches to attend a World Conference of Mennonites and experience the racial, national, and economic diversity of the Mennonite Church. Buhler Mennonite Church members attended and opened their homes and lives to conference travelers from all over the world. Renovation of the church building basement began at the beginning of 1979, and by late 1979, the congregation began renovating the sanctuary and completed it in the spring of 1980 in time for Easter services. During the sanctuary remodeling, the congregation worshiped in the church basement. Reverend Kraus served the Buhler Mennonite Church until 1985. After his time at Buhler, he served the Bethel Mennonite Church of Hydro, Oklahoma, until his untimely death during surgery in 1992. Dr. D.C. Wadle was again called to lead the congregation as interim pastor, and he did so for 6 months. Reverend Malcolm and Esther Winger served the church an additional 6 months until the congregation could find a new full-time pastor. Reverend Winger hailed from Aberdeen, Idaho, and attended Bethel College. He passed away in Wichita, Kansas in 2003. These interim pastors were greatly appreciated and brought encouragement to the congregation. In July of 1986 began the longest pastoral tenure in Buhler's 100-year ministry. It lasted 27 years, just over one quarter of Buhler Mennonite Church's existence. Reverend Robert Dahlke, a Kansas native and Bethel College graduate, was installed as the next pastor. He had previously served pastorates in California and Oklahoma. Reverend Dahlke immediately offered an energetic, friendly, and personable style of ministering. It was very easy to engage in conversation with him, but very difficult not to end up laughing because of his prodigious sense of humor and ability to find a story for almost every situation. During his pastorate, Reverend Dahlke realized the need to bring youth back to the church. Several assistant and youth pastors were employed throughout the years to focus on youth ministry. One such pastor was Alan Stuckey, a ministerial student at Bethel College, who served the congregation's youth for 3 years before entering seminary. Stuckey was instrumental in helping develop a joint youth ministry between Hufnungsau Inman and Buhler Mennonite churches. After Stuckey's tenure, Reverend Dahlke helped develop, along with Hufnungsau Mennonite and Inman Mennonite, a full-time youth/assistant pastor position. Hufnungsau Mennonite Church attendee Matthew Simon was called to serve in this position in 2007. Reverend Dahlke also challenged the church with a new purpose in Christian living. As Buhler Mennonite Church historian Lois Schrader wrote, quote, "We were challenged by unconventional definitions of worship, fellowship, discipleship, ministry, and evangelism, was a blueprint for Christian living in the 21st century, a lifestyle based on God's eternal purpose, not cultural values." End of quote. In 1995, Buhler Mennonite Church grandly celebrated a year of jubilee, 75 years of ministry. In 1999, the Hebron Mennonite Church of Buhler, Kansas, was considering merging with Buhler Mennonite Church. And it is of interest to note that church records show that merger discussions existed already in the 1960s. But on June 4, 2000, 88 Hebron Mennonite Church members were received by merger. These new members created an invaluable infusion of energy, creativity, leadership, and guidance. Reverend Dahlke retired at the end of 2013 after serving the church for 27 years. He and his wife Floretta still reside in Buhler, and he serves as pastor of senior ministries at Bethel Mennonite Church, Inman, Kansas. Reverend Dahlke offered this blessing to the Buhler Mennonite Church. Quote, "We pray that as you begin a new 100 years, you continue to live in the miracle of God with us in Jesus Christ, His love filling and flowing in and through you, and the miracle of being the church to a very hurting world. You are good at it." End of quote. Reverend Lee Suderman was called to serve as an intentional interim pastor. He had previously served as interim pastor at Hufnungsau Mennonite Church and lead pastor of Alexanderwald Mennonite Church in Gosel after moving to Kansas from California. Reverend Suderman left no stone unturned as he prepared the church to transition from a 27-year ministry to a new minister. He left behind a bountiful harvest of helpful church data and interpretation for the next pastor. The next pastor was still living in the Southern Hemisphere when Buhler Mennonite Church contacted him about considering the open pastoral position. He and his family were not strangers to the Buhler and Inman communities. In August of 2014, Reverend Wilmer T. Harder, a Mountain Lake, Minnesota native and a Bethel College graduate, was called as the next pastor of Buhler Mennonite Church. His brother, Dr. David Harder, and family were already regular attendees of Buhler Mennonite Church when he arrived. Reverend Harder had served from 2001 and 2010 as the lead pastor of Hoffnungshau Mennonite Church before he and his family moved to Bolivia to serve as the coordinators of the Low German Mennonite program of the Mennonite Central Committee. After 4 years of service with MCC in Bolivia, they moved back to Kansas. The congregation granted him permission to live outside of the Buhler city limits on a farm he already owned 5 miles southeast of Buhler. His ministry at Hoffnungshau helped him know many Buhler members, as well as the joint youth group ministry. An early emphasis of Reverend Harder's ministry included a focus on mental health and well-being. This focus resulted in the hosting of the Mennonite acting troupe called Ted and Company, held in the Buhler High School auditorium. An estimated 600 people from all over central Kansas attended the event. A major ministry that came out of this focus was the gathering of concerned Buhler citizens wanting to address the issue of substance abuse and addiction. Reverend Harder was asked to chair this group of people from a variety of area organizations and churches. The gathering resulted in the opening of the Buhler Omega House, a faith-based residential addiction recovery house. The group purchased the old Wall House on the corner of First and Wall Streets in Buhler. The first resident moved into the house in March of 2020. The congregation and community have helped make this ministry a success. In 2020, the congregation gave Pastor Wilmer a 3-month sabbatical. Reverend Kurt Horst filled in. Little could Reverend Horst and the church anticipate the events of the next year. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, Buhler Mennonite Church stopped meeting in person, and Reverend Horst and BMC member Peter Buhler began to develop online services. The little used word and technology, Zoom, became a mainstay for connecting. All services remained online or via Zoom until June, when Pastor Wilmer and the congregation celebrated baptism at Camp Minniska. They met in person, but socially distancing and wearing masks until November, when COVID-19 spiked again in Reno County. Pastor Wilmer got sick, as well as nearly 50 members. 3 congregational deaths were attributed to COVID-19. The January annual congregational meeting was held in person, but in the church parking lot, where attendees stayed in their cars and the leaders spoke through microphones that were broadcast on 98.7 FM. Affirmations and praise were expressed by the honking of the car horns.
These honk their horns in praise. And all the Toyotas and Hondas. And all the others that haven't honked their horn, honk your horn in praise. Let all of God's people let Buhler know that God rules by honking their horn.
Several weeks later, the church began meeting in person again. About half of the regular Sunday morning attendees met in person, while the other half watched the services via live stream online on YouTube. During this time, the Buhler Mennonite Church sound system and video recording and broadcasting capabilities were exponentially upgraded and improved. As Buhler Mennonite Church moves into its second 100 years of ministry, Reverend Harder continues as the congregation's lead pastor. Although all Buhler Mennonite Church members throughout the years have served as ministers, God has blessed Buhler Mennonite Church with faithful and able servants to fulfill the calling of Eltesta, or pastor. Just as God has provided faithful shepherds for the Buhler Mennonite Church, surely God will continue to provide faithful shepherds far into our future.
wonderful video. Pastor Wilmer must be commended for his work with these. It was wonderful to see a lot of the old faces again. Shall we close with a prayer, and then it'll be about time for service here. So if you bow with me, please. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you again for your many blessings upon us. We ask that you continue to keep your protective hand over us in the coming week, and ask that you bless our endeavors. We ask all this in your name. Amen.